What are polynomials, types of polynomials, degree of polynomials, and exam-based questions of polynomials? Firstly, let me teach you that how algebraic terms are formed. Well, every algebraic term is made up of three things, C, V, and P. C stands for constant or coefficient, V stands for variable, and P stands for power. For example, consider 2y cubed. It is an algebraic term because 2 is the constant part, y is the variable part, and 3 is the power part. So constant part of the term is made up of numbers like 2, 300, 1000, etc. While the variable part of the term is made up of English alphabets like A, B, C, D, etc. And the power part of the term is again made up of numbers like 1, 2, 3, etc. Remember that this 2y cubed means that 2 and 2y cubed, but we eliminate the sign of multiplication and we just write 2y cubed. Thus remember that algebraic term is made up of constant part, variable part, and power part. Now let me give you some examples of algebraic terms like 14xy, 33abc squared, 5hk, minus 7p squared, q squared. Now 14xy is algebraic term because 14 is the constant, xy are variables, the power of x is 1 and the power of y is also 1. Remember that we do not write 1 in the power. 33abc squared is also algebraic term because 33 is constant, abc are variables, the power of a is 1, that of b is also 1 and that of c is 2. 5hk is also algebraic term because 5 is constant, h and k are variables, the power of h and k is 1. Minus 7p squared q squared is algebraic term because minus 7 is a constant, p and q are variables, the power of p and q is 2. Thus these all are the algebraic terms. Now let me teach you that how we combine different algebraic terms together. Firstly, you must know the positive or negative sign of the constant part of algebraic terms. For example, in this case, the sign of 14 is positive. In this case, the sign of 33 is positive. In this case, the sign of 5 is also positive. While in this case, the sign of 7 is negative. Now I take this term and write it here, plus 14xy. I take this term and write it here, plus 33abc squared. So I have joined two terms. Secondly, I take this and write it here, plus 5hk. I take this and write it here, minus 7p squared q squared. So again I have joined two terms. Now listen carefully. This is one term and this is another term. These two terms are joined together by the positive sign. Also this is one term and this is another term. These two terms are joined together by the negative sign. From this example, we learn that to combine different algebraic terms, we either put positive sign or negative sign between them. So by putting positive or negative sign among them, we can join different algebraic terms. Now let me take a quick test from you. Find the number of terms in the following questions. Pause the video and count them quickly. Well, we have already learned in our previous example that positive sign and negative sign separate terms from each other. It is first term, second term, and third term. So there are three terms present in it. You may be thinking that why 5 is a term? Well, we can write 5x to the power 0 because x to the power 0 is 1, or 5 into 1 is equal to 5. So 5 is also algebraic term. Secondly, this is first term, second term, third term, and fourth term. So there are four terms present in it. Thirdly, this is first term, second term, third term, fourth term, and fifth term. So there are five terms present in it. Hence, note it down that positive and negative signs separate algebraic terms. Now, what are polynomials? Well, the answer is simple. You have already learned the polynomials. The word polynomial is formed from two parts, poly and nomials. Poly means many and nomial means terms. So polynomial means many terms. Now let's consider different algebraic terms like 5x, 3x plus 2, 3x minus 5 plus 4, 5y plus 6 minus 2y plus 8. We know that this is one term, here there are two terms, here there are three terms, here there are four terms. Now listen carefully. Instead of this one term, I write mono, and instead of term, I write nomial, because mono means one and nomial means term. Similarly, instead of two terms, I write bi and nomial. Instead of three terms, I write tri and nomial. Also, instead of four terms, I write poly and nomial. Thus, if there is one term, it is called monomial. If there are two terms, it is called binomial. If there are three terms, it is called trinomial. If there are four or more terms, it is called polynomial. Here, let me clear one of the main confusion of students. They say that monomial is not a polynomial. It is totally wrong. Monomial is a polynomial. Binomial is a polynomial. Trinomial is a polynomial. And polynomial is a polynomial. To learn this, let me give you my personal logic. Consider this crowd of people. I take one person out of this crowd. Isn't this single person belong to these people? Well, the answer is yes. This single person belong to these people. Similarly, this single term or monomial belongs to crowd of polynomials because it is taken out from the crowd of polynomials. Just remember about monomial, binomial, trinomial and polynomial. Now what are the rules of polynomials? Well, there is one rule that determines either the algebraic term or terms are polynomial or not. The rule is that the power of the algebraic term must be a whole number. For example, consider 5x squared, 3y to the power negative 2, 5y to the power 2.3, 12x to the power 2 upon 3. Here, the power of x is 2, which belongs to whole number, so it is a polynomial. Here, the power of y is minus 2. It doesn't belong to whole number, so it is not a polynomial. Here, the power of y is 2.3. It doesn't belong to whole number, so it is not a polynomial. Here, the power of x is 2 upon 3. 2 upon 3 doesn't belong to whole number, so it is not a polynomial. Hence, only 5x squared is a polynomial and the rest of algebraic terms are not polynomials because their powers do not belong to whole number. Now, let me take a quick test from you. Which are the polynomials in the following questions? Pause the video and try to solve them. Well, we can write minus 8 as minus 8x to the power 0. We know that x to the power 0 is equal to 1. Or minus 8 into 1 is equal to 8. The power of x is 0, it belongs to whole number, so minus 8 is a polynomial. There is one term, so it is also called monomial. Secondly, the power of x is 3, so it is polynomial. There are two terms, so it is also called binomial. Thirdly, the power of a is 1 and the power of b is 1, so it is polynomial as well as trinomial. Fourthly, the power of p is 1, that of q is 1, and that of r is 1. So it is polynomial as well as binomial. Fifthly, the power of y is 1, and the power of x is 1 upon 2. 1 upon 2 doesn't belong to whole number, so it is not a polynomial. Sixthly, the power of this x is 2, and when we shift this x from denominator to numerator, its power becomes negative 1. Negative 1 doesn't belong to whole number, so it is not a polynomial. Thus note it down all these questions. Finally, let me teach you the degree of polynomials. Well, the degree of polynomials indicate the highest power in the polynomial. For example, consider these polynomials. In this polynomial, there are two variables, x and y. The power of x is 1, and that of y is also 1. The highest power is 1, so it is 1 degree polynomial. Secondly, the power of x is 2, and the power of this x is 1. The highest power is 2, so it is second degree polynomial. Thirdly, the power of p is 3, and that of r is 1. The highest power is 3, so it is third degree polynomial. Fourthly, the power of x is 2 and the power of y is 1. X and y are present in the same term, so add their respective powers. 2 plus 1 is equal to 3. The power of this y is 1. The highest power is 3, so it is third degree polynomial. Fifthly, the power of a is 3 and b is 2. 3 plus 2 is 5. Here, the power of a is 2 and b is 1. 2 plus 1 is equal to 3. The highest power is 5, so it is fifth degree polynomial. Thus, by this way, we can find the degree of any polynomial. I hope that you have learned all about polynomials.